Hey guys, welcome back to Moon Chaser. I really like this one over here. I should make it function. Anywho. What do we get? We shall open up. Have our T600 on a fuel tender trailer. I think that's actually filled up. I had to go and pick up the Duramax after I'm done bailing here. And, sprayer, that's my sprayer. Added in a new house, courtesy of another map maker, SketchUp model, but looks really good. Definitely reminds me of houses back home in Minnesota, so it's definitely representative. It's almost identical to my parents' neighbor's house. We'll take the back road to our farm. Currently in the middle of tillage, some of our bigger fields. Field one up here, I think Mateus finished. I hammered out like half of it the other night and got tired and went to bed, so. So I have quite a bit left to do in field 2, but field 1 looks like it's all plowed. Slowly but surely making progress. 13's ready now. Won't take long to finish up field 2. Probably an hour. Then we have 13, 14, and get all the fields back here. But little by little, we're plugging away at our primary tillage. So this will all be farmed in here. All that grass will be plowed in. I guess we'll just go down to the dealer and park this down there for now. So you can see that 17's been plowed in, 17 and 18. We have quite a bit to till over here though. We own pretty much all these fields, so it's less tillage. I think we have 10, 6, and 7, and 15, 11, and 12 won't be chisel plowed because it's soybean, so we'll probably just cultivate this land right here. So mowed another crop of hay off of the north part of 11, merged it, all nice and neat. And then there's a tractor repairer in the middle of the road. I pulled our ramps here and leave our truck here for the time being. We use one of our tillage rigs. 27.7 hours on this one. Here's another one. This one is 28 on the nose. Hopefully this is a good line. Cleaning up this edge a little bit. Should be good. So people keep asking me, even though I explained it in the last video, why are we plowing in perfectly good beans? Well, look at this little HUD indicator. It says nutrients, nitrogen, zero. Nutrients, potassium, zero. Phosphorus and potassium, zero. The yield would be absolutely horrendous. It wouldn't even be probably worth the fuel price to harvest this. So what we're doing is we sprayed NPK with our sprayers. Now we're just tilling in, getting the benefits of that green soil mod, the benefits of tilling in the crop. And so by doing so, this field that was basically a wasteland is going to be right back up to where it should be, into productive levels. If we were to harvest all these acres, we could probably make, a couple hundred thousand or whatever it would be, but really, it's not even worth it because it's the time it would take to harvest everything, the amount of money we would spend on herbicide, and we would get benefits of the chopped straw, yeah, but it's just a lot easier to just plow it under without really losing any money at all. We're just basically saving ourselves a couple hours, 10 hours of harvesting for basically. What is he doing? And it helps save us soil pH, less acidic, so. Because every time you spray any kind of nutrients or herbicide, you're slowly decreasing or increasing the acidity of the soil, or, you know, decreasing the pH. So, not that big a deal, but I mean, it costs money and it takes time to have that limestone actually incorporate into the soil. I mean, you have to go through a whole updated growth stage for it to reflect any change. And, you know, if you just broadcast it without tilling it in, you don't get as much of an increase, which is, you know, a good thing. There is some control, you know, if you don't need that big of a spike. pH to get it back to a basic soil pH, but it will definitely be a lot quicker of tillage next season. We pretty much have to plow in all of these newly acquired land. Even though we don't own it, we lease it, so we're still farming it, so when we do buy it, it's going to be less work required up front, because we're putting in all the time now to get it back up to respectable levels. When we used the MP when I was hosting, we farmed this field maybe one or two seasons, so it's overall a really easy field to harvest. Gives coarse play a little bit of an issue right here around this kind of like peninsula section, but you know, that's coarse play. Nice to see that we're farming all this land again. We really went heavy on the loan and leased a bunch of land. It's costing us $10,000 a day just to rent all the land. So it's definitely not cheap to be farming all this land. Just the land cost alone is going to cost us, you know, $250,000 just in leasing fees for this harvest. So right off the bat, we're $250K in the hole on land, and then you have to factor in probably like another $100,000 in fuel, seed, and spray nutrients. So you know, we're $350,000 in the hole, but we're probably looking at $1.5 million in gross revenue. So overall, we'll probably come out very well. Unfortunately, we still have a $2.2 million loan, but we still have all of our crop. We have all of our soybean, we have all of our canola, we have all of our corn. None of that has been sold, so I think after we sell all of that and we sell this next season's grain, we'll probably be debt-free. Where we can potentially take out another loan, and instead of leasing land, we can just purchase it. We can probably purchase additional equipment. So I'll probably have to run the numbers and spec out what we actually need, because it's kind of inconvenient to rent additional equipment when we can just own it. It's not cost effective to own, but it's more convenient because we don't always have to be going to the dealer and stuff like that. So I was thinking of maybe investing in a big Lexion combine in addition to our 990. The issue is, like, if I were to get a Lexion with a bin extension, we We can only really handle a 12-row header on our 990 right now just because of the yield. If we do our management right, the yield is, you know, pretty high with the 12-row header and stock bin, you know, 14,000 whatever liters it was, and 400 bushels. Where the Lexion has a, I think it's like a 750 bushel capacity, or something like that. So naturally, you'd want to go with a 16-row corn header, but when you're farming in the, when you're picking in the same field, it's just really, it doesn't really work with a GPS. And, I mean, obviously you can make it work, but it's just much easier if you're running the same working width, so you can just pick up the same line and not really have to think when you're harvesting, and it's just more efficient. But I think if we were to invest in a big Lexion, we would have the extra bin capacity. So then when we would hit probably close to $100 on our 990, we can trade that in as well and pick up, you know, trade that in a bigger combine with larger capacity. So. We might pick up a Cat Challenger tractor too, and bigger grain cart, and, you know, just kind of expand our operation. Because right now our 1050 Kinsey, it's a little bit inefficient right now with our operation. I'd rather just have one big 1500 bushel cart with a little bit quicker unload rate, and it fills up the entire truck, not three quarters of the truck. So, but that's. All of that's, you know, at least the entire season away, if not two seasons away. So, I mean, our T9s are doing a terrific job with our tillage equipment. We still don't even own planters. We're still renting planters just because they're so expensive to buy. And we don't really... planting goes so quick compared to everything else, but we're getting there with our land. We're farming probably maybe like a third, probably not quite, but getting close to a third of the map. So I think if we were to pick up one or two more fields, we'd probably be right at the one-third mark. I definitely want to plant some barley this season, a couple fields of barley, and probably another big field of canola. I want to go a little bit more heavy on corn. We went heavy on beans, but our corn, I really want to get around 1.5 million liters of corn in. We have the capacity with three guys on trucks to unload and sell to 2.5 million in theory within an hour to Conagra. We were just running the numbers because I think me and Jake ourselves, we unloaded 1.4 million within an hour alone. With time to spare. I think we figured it was around, I think it was 2.2 or 2.5 million liters of grain we can sell within an hour. But that's like the maximum. There's no fudge factor in there. That's 100% efficient. So I figured if we get around 2.2 million liters, we'd be able to sell that pretty comfortably, because that's 300 liters less, 300,000 liters less. That's six less truckloads we'd have to do. So six less truckloads, you're looking at 5 minutes of truck a load. So basically, if you have three trucks going, you know, that's 10 minutes at least that you would cut off your transport time. Maybe. I think we were actually doing round trips around anywhere from, it seemed like 3 to 4 minutes we were doing a round trip. Maybe it was 5 minutes. A complete round trip. Which wasn't bad. And you know, if we have a little bit of grain left over, no big deal. But that just means we could have planted another crop, you know, more. We could have planted more of another crop and took advantage of selling that. So, and we really don't have any great demands coming up for the next 4 days at least. Well, a great demand for anything that we have. So we're just kind of in a situation. That's why I started on that second hay crop. Just because hopefully that will give us, you know, really hoping for 30 to 40,000 worth of bales off of the two areas that I mowed and windrowed. So that would help carry us through 4 days without taking out any more loans to, you know, carry us through this intermarried period of no income. And then hopefully we'd be getting close to a great demand where we can start to pay off some of our debt. But it's kind of fun. We're playing on, you know, really, you know, the difficulty 3, which is hard, and all of our prices, like our corn spec'd at $4.50 a bushel. Our soybeans is like $10 a bushel. You know, the yields of beans around 70 bushel an acre. Corn's like 250 bushel an acre. And, you know, that's 100% ideal. And with soil management, that only decreases based on moisture and nutrients, so it makes it fun and challenging, and you actually have to farm a lot of acres to have a pretty decent income stream. We're using that finance mod too, which taxes us on our income and it taxes us on our land value, so I'm not really sure if that applies to our leased land or not. I'm not really sure how that works, but I know it taxes you on the value of land that you own, I think, so. But overall, going to the 2720, I think, was a really good choice. Excuse me. Excuse me. Covering a lot more ground now, and so head back to our T8, bail up some hay bales. So I was having an issue with having alfalfa regrow like grass before I installed soil mod, and because with soil mod it kind of like withers, and I was really confused. So I sent Decker a message on FSUK, and he replied pretty promptly, and gave me a pretty detailed explanation on growth states and growth rates and max cut states and stuff like that, and explain how to set it up. So, because for whatever reason, it just seemed really confusing. I was looking at definitions of, what everything meant, and, I kind of had an idea, and knew, but it's so hard to actually test. Once you're in game, so it's just best to get it, from someone that understands it better and can explain it pretty clearly, which demonstrates a pretty firm understanding of it. So hopefully the issue of my alfalfa not regrowing is solved, which I think it is. So I will only have to plant it once and forget it. And it's going to be really good because it yields more than grass. We can do soil management on it. I think grass is only affected by soil mod if it's under a field terrain. Because on this bare ground, I don't even know if it has any effect. Really. So that got me excited. That means less plowing and tillage with alfalfa, and it's, you can just plant it once and forget it, and just keep on mowing it and baling it. And, I might be a little bit realistic and probably till it up after four seasons, because I know alfalfa, you can get maybe 3 to 5 seasons of cuts off of it until you pretty much have to replant it. You can obviously leave it, but it's going to start being overrun by other kind of grasses, and the yield will be low, and quality isn't there, so just till it up and plant again. But definitely, I was contemplating just planting grass and saying screw it with alfalfa, because, I messed around a few times with it, and it was just a little frustrating. So we shall see if the changes actually work. Crossing my fingers. So right now you can see our intake is pretty low compared to the in-game map, but what can you do? We have 1, 2, 3, 4 bales. How the clip distance of these bales has gone down. With that new patch, it seems like the clip distance has decreased. Either that or I noticed that there's a lot of differences when I host a multiplayer game versus on this dedicated server. There's a lot of features and functions that don't work and things that are different, so I think it just might be a nature of the server itself, so. Merged these rows a little bit differently this time, the long way, and it seemed to work really well. Really like that added the new functions on the merger, the change, like left and right discharge on each of the pickups, and raise and lower. And works pretty slick. Love this baler. The baler looks so cool. Whoa. Just a nice little hay field to bale on. Pretty easy way to make some money. Low cost to, you know, there's pretty much no real expense involved in. this is probably my favorite entrance to a farm. Need to put a house somewhere over here. Protect them back here in the trees, maybe. So here we go. Have never mowed and baled this little section, so this is field 28, 26, and 25. Each one of these bales is roughly $1,200, so and we rent a merger for like $400. We rented this baler for like $400, so we have $800 in rental fees. Then we'll probably rent the telehandler and bale fork and bale stacker, you know, for a combined, you know, 500. So for the cost of the single bale, we can, you know, get 40 bales. So that's a pretty low cost of production. Obviously, like, we haven't even started to do any kind of forestry either, so I have a couple log trailers. I really want to use that big semi-trailer wood chipper that was released on, I don't know how to pronounce it, M-A-H-E-R or something like that. You know, the guy that keeps making all kind, you know, he's really good at writing LUA files and stuff like that, but it's like Big Green or Big Boy or something like that. It's just a monster sized wood chipper. So that's all we wrote for bales. see a field too is in the midst of being plowed. 18 is 17 and finished. Nice thing about 44 is you don't have to chisel plow 44, it's already doing pretty well in its nutrients, so probably end the video here because all I have to do is collect, stack, and sell bales, which is not the most interesting thing in the world, but what else do we have going on? We have a truck down here. Added in some new stores and stuff right here, like a little side road. So that's new little addition. And, working on adding more lake houses and stuff like that. Bale cells right up there, little red shed. And, can't wait to get over to these fields, these monster fields over here. Just, I think we'll probably turn those into big, some kind of grain or some kind of oil seeds. Or, otherwise, you can see we're pretty much farming this entire section over here, and then obviously this is part of the big grain and dairy beef complex, and then this over here is just kind of up for grabs for anyone that wants to travel and farm it. There's a grain facilities way over there that you can buy and stuff. And another nice paved gravel road with lake houses. So overall, really not much to it. It's just a lot of just really big. Trying to add more detail and stuff like that, make it more realistic and more scenic when you're playing. So, but this is the newest little tidbit, just kind of like clean that up. So, thanks for watching.